Welcome back, everybody. Playing some more Black Myth Wukong. Hours after my last video, I had to look up how to defeat this wind demon. It turns out I need this thing called like the Wind Tamer to help things go a lot smoother for me. But in the meantime, I boosted my character a little bit further. I added another, like, did I add this? I'm pretty sure I did, like, slightly increase the health recovery rate upon consuming a focus point. And this, and this. I increased the health of my duplicates. And got another critical hit point. Yeah. Not much, but I think this helps. So I already did the first part by, you know, of the, you know, trying to obtain the Wind Tamer. I already did part of it, which gave that pig creature something to drink or something like that, after I got some items from the man in stone. I need to acquire something else at this forest. So I'm gonna like mute myself and just follow the guide to complete the rest of this stuff. Yeah, just acquired this part. Now I'm gonna probably get back to that pig who has moved to the Tiger Vanguard location. Thank you.
This putrid rat meat is insufferable. Help me score a tasty treat, will you? It drives me mad. I've been craving a taste of that juicy jade lotus. Can you find me some in this barren land? I wouldn't mind some meatless meals from time to time. I have stumbled upon some interesting leads. The realm of gold does hold a connection to this desolate land. I hear the realm of gold is where the sun sets. There, they held rats above all others. And somehow, before we knew it, the realm was gone. Quite odd, that is. I just tried those rat guise. They taste like men flesh. Its people are not yet extinct. I suspect the Yellow Wind Gwai had a role in their downfall. Our senior brother gave me a piece of gold. I'll need it here when the time's right, he said. It's the right time now. I'm taking it to the right place to give it a try. I just tried those rat guise. They taste like men flesh. Its people are not yet our senior brother. It's the right time now. I'm taking it to the right place to give it a try. I just tried those. Its people. It's the right time.
Okay, he should be going back to where we first found him. And because he'll be like a boss, which is an easy boss, but we want to do some kind of fighting.
gold piece. Intensity! This is good. You and I should explore that realm together.
Okay. Let's go to another boss fight. For a short duration after using the gourd, Madalia increases attack. Refraining from using gourd for a relatively long duration, Madalia reduces attack on the contrary. Oh, that was really worth it. Hey Louise, I'm doing all right. Hey, are you just Saint Louise with just with a different, like, numerical thing on your side of your name? All right, in silken robes that flutter bright, a long snouted guai with eyes alight, drunk with joy, he sleeps on tombs forlorn. His spear and armor gleams like dawn. Windy, searing sun, a vast waste. A headless monk and a yellow-robed squire rested together under a withered tree. The monk plucked at the strings of his sansin, his body swaying gently to and fro. "Enough," said the squire, rousing himself. Let's have some peace." The monk's hand stilled. He edged away, then raised his hand to strum again. Yeah, heal. Ignore that.
Men in our time do not see the ancient moon, but this moon hath shone on men of yore. Behold! Be it the realm of sunset or the realm of gold, it's but an echo of the past. Legends speak of an ancient, colossal beetle in these sands. Whilst deep in slumber, it lay hidden beneath the Earth's embrace. When awakened, it would devour all souls that crossed its path. Its shell, harder than stone, defied the strikes of common arms. It struck fear into traveling merchants and wider to neighboring realms. But a yellow-furred rat sensed the immense power emanating from the insect. He halted the beetle's havoc and harnessed it for his own end. Overjoyed, the king named the rat Gwai, the royal sage, and built a shrine in his honor. The bound beetle was a perfect source of power, so the rat stayed. He seized the tongue monk using the new power, and battled with Sun Wukong upon the Yellow Wind Ridge. The Gwai's formidable wings veiled the vast expanse of the sky. Were it not for Bodhisattva Lingji, Tongue Monk's quest for the scriptures would have failed. Yet, stripped of the rat's protection, the kingdom was plunged into a state of ruin. The once lush Yellow Wind Ridge now lies a desolate wasteland.
Obsession! Disgrace. Save real quick. check something here.
You traveler,
he's back.
I'll meet your ends here. I am the vanguard of the Yellow Wind. You scorn my words? I'll have you served to the king's dinner. Grand might. brave soul, why not use this might to aid my king's good deed?
My back!
There he is. Upon successful hits with like combo attack, mildly increase attack pressure. Oh wow, that is so useful. Okay, next step. I gotta fight this subterranean beetle, which is that silhouetted thing that that wind demon was throwing at me. So I gotta get something off of his back. And of course there would be like a already a shrine. Let's see if there's any collectibles.
You bested my vanguard. Then you do indeed have skills. That Yao Guai must have some vessel that counters me. Even my Samadhi wind can't hurt it. There is only one way to draw out this Yao Guai. I'll sound the drums and it'll come forth. If you are willing, I ask you to seize its vessel at the right time. Then the Yao Guai will be mine.
Western end of the world. Each day the sun sets and boils the sea. The boiling hiss is sharp enough to wrap its babies.
Side of his arms. So much my healing on just the first half.
You
On the folks' behalf, I thank you.
Okay, I should have. I went to the cellar. Now I should be good to go, but I want to double check really quick. Okay, from what the guy says, this will help immensely. Get this. Increase my chances to lower this guy's health. Okay. Here we go. What the hell? What happened to my my thing? I thought I'd be fully charged. We'll go through this again.
Yeah.
A skinny wretch like you has come far enough!
Thank you.
Any wretch like you has come far enough!
Yeah!
Any wretch like you has come far enough!
Kill!
I thought this thing charges up. I can use it probably like a second time, but I probably got to wait until this round to use the Wind Tamer.
Any wretch like you has come far enough!
Yeah!
Yeah. Alright, I lost too much life and I didn't want to waste anything else. So close, man. It's so freaking dumb.
You stole Erlang's spell and snatched the great sage's relic. You even took your master's heed. Just for a short reign over this barren valley.
Thank you. Bodhisattva Lingji of New Mount Sumeru. The warden of this rat. After the great sage's passing, his six senses were scattered across the mortal realm. This thieving rat chanced upon one of them, yet hindered by his meager might, he could not absorb its power. Thus he schemed with wicked intent, a victim of his deceit. I had my hand taken by him. The sense requires such a grand container to release its power. I should bear the blame for his reign of havoc upon this ridge again. Through your valor and sagacity, order has been restored. You are the sole worthy one to keep it. Please, keep it secure in my stead.
That was a fun claymation. This is dope. I feel like I'm watching Star Wars Visions right now. That's one hell of a nightmare. Damn, killed that wolf. Pretty effed up, man. Just healed the
beasts.
Just healed the animal and just put it on his way.
Yogwais. Each of them bears a distinct root from birth. Superior and inferior. None should disturb what's decided. Am I right, Sun Wukong?
That's the end of chapter 2.
With the wind and sand you've endured here, did you reach the Forgotten Kingdom at the end of the land? Did you find the Clash of Stones and the fall of Tiger's Acolyte? If you shut your ears and heed only your inner murmur, I fear the more you yearn for flawless endings, the further you'll stray from the path. Rats and cats, neither grasped their destiny, and yet neither admitted it. Listen closely, young one. Their complaints ride upon the wind.
This. Fuming ears. From the faintest noise capture the deepest significance. Bold ventures bring forth pride and resistance. Echoes of the past can be found where karma lingers. Okay, all ears. Slowly extends invincibility duration of the first move. Combos. Sound as a bell. Narrows the window of rock solid deflection, but returns half the mana. This is more useful. Hold on to this, unless I run up against a beast with fire abilities, then I have to switch over to the other thing. Oh, let me get back to this guy. From emptiness, desires arise, bringing strife. From compassion, lust grows vast as life. Past joys turn to future regrets, cleanse the heart, let go as the wind sets. The reasons behind Basitiva's Lingua's beheading were widely debated. Tiger Vanguard put it this way: how could we mere followers dare to discuss the master's affairs? However, I once heard my father mention that our master despised that Batsitava of some sort. Their so-called master-disciple bond. To me, it was more about merely seeking protection. Being a Yagwai, you got to be pragmatic. Immortals and Buddhas don't show mercy. It's all about mutual benefit. The king of following San seemed to know more details. Years ago, when Master helped my humble kingdom avert disasters, I caught a glimpse of the big beetle. It had a Buddha head on its back, identical to the one Master beheaded. Alas, everyone in my kingdom turned into rats later. Master said it was a calamity he brought upon us and left with his followers. I know he didn't want to leave. He always wanted Yagwais to live dignified lives. The second prince was terse. Master? Not bad. The Bastava deserved it. Ma Timba, passing through, sighed and said, an oil-stealing rat climbs high only if someone sets up a ladder. Yellow Wind Sage had only one comment about the matter. Those who bring disaster upon others will have disaster brought upon themselves. If not by me, then by someone else. Yes. Okay. Don't work with like the pillar and thrust stances. Performing a heavy attack during a light combo will consume a focus point. I'm gonna see how this works. And this. At least one point between the two of them. Then apply a point here on these two. There was a door that I discovered but didn't go through because I thought it triggered some other boss fight because I was not streaming that day. So at some point I gotta come back and find that door again. Master of Disguise. I know you're alive. Unless he sensed me and then decided to turn to stone. This is mine now. Oh shit, scared the crap out of me. I was trying to look at the scenery. Something tells me I'm probably gonna need a chill potions. All right, I think we're good for this game for today. Finally beat that freaking sage. God, I wish I would have known about the, I should have looked it up a lot sooner in order to acquire that equipment so I can get past that freaking beast sooner, but whatever. At least it gave me a chance to like grind and get myself up in points a little bit. So at least for the next boss or two, I should have like a better go of it until something heavier comes along, possibly towards the end of the chapter or halfway through this chapter. But anyway, I'm gonna grab me something to eat first, and then I am gonna hop back to some Destiny 2. But anyway, yeah, that was fun. Despite the issues I have with certain of the bosses, I'm still having a great time. And thank you for stopping by, and I'll see you guys soon. Take care.